Hi all, my name is Hera Shaheen and today we will discuss how to clear UGC NET computer science exam. Okay, first of all I would like to tell you that to clear qualify any competitive exam or any exam, you have to plan your schedule. Okay, you have to plan everything, that how you will study, which subjects you have to study, which time and at what time you have to do what. Okay, everything. And the next important thing is to follow that plan. And the next important thing is, hard work is the key to success. Remember that Rome was not built in a day, or heights by great men reached and kept were not attained by sudden flight. They, while their companions slept, were toiling upwards in the night. What does it mean? It means that you cannot achieve success in a day, or you think that you will sit in a flight and you will go to that height. That means you have to do lot of hard work to achieve success. To reach to the height of those people who have attained greatness. Okay, so try to do that. And one thing more, coming to the UGC NET computer science exam, one thing I must tell you, that even if you prepare very well for paper 2 and paper 3 and you don't do well in paper 1, you cannot qualify the exam. So never neglect paper 1, because paper 1 is the most scoring subject in UGC NET exam, in any paper. If you do well in paper 1 and paper 2 and paper 3, if you do qualifying, then also you can clear the NET exam. Okay, so there are so many topics in paper 1, like teaching aptitude, research aptitude and quantitative aptitude, reading comprehension, environment and polity, higher education, reading comprehension, logical reasoning, mathematical reasoning. There are so many topics. Okay, so don't neglect paper 1. Okay, I'll just tell you that what are the topics you have to study in paper 1, 2 and 3.
So for paper 1, you have to study these topics I have written over there. Oh, these are teaching aptitude, research aptitude, reading comprehension, communication, reasoning and quantitative aptitude, logical reasoning, data analysis and interpretation, information and communication technology, people and environment interaction, higher education system, which consists of government, polity and administration. You have to do all these things in for paper 1. Okay, so don't neglect any topic. Now we'll see for what are the topics you have to study for paper 2 and paper 3. These are the topics for paper 2 and paper 3, which consists of algorithms, data structure, C and C++ programming, operating system, computer network, theory of computation, compiler design, digital logic, computer organization, predicate logic, discrete mathematics, artificial intelligence, fuzzy logic and neural network, database management system, operation research, graph theory, and one more thing is software engineering. Okay, so these are the core areas I have written here. Maybe some topic is missing here, but these are the core areas from where most of the questions are asked. Okay, so do prepare from these topics, for sure. Don't leave this topic. And many other things I'll tell you.
So start preparing from now, okay, or today only. Don't wait for tomorrow. Don't ever say that you will start from tomorrow or day after tomorrow, because time and tide wait for none. Okay, that's why don't waste time. If you waste time, time will waste you. And now what do you do? from now only or today only, schedule, make your schedule, make your timetable and follow the plan or follow your schedule. If you are not following your plan, that means you are planning to fail. So best of luck. Thanks.